not sure this is the best lighting. But I put my footing up. Okay. So I focus somewhere. So this week we're talking about we're talking about wardrobe for interviews. Now, honestly, I don't have much experience with this. Last time I went for an interview, I had long hair. I don't know if what I have to say will be helpful at all. But, okay. So, being trans, I would dress like a guy. Obviously. But a lot of people have been asking about this, so I don't know. I would wear black pants, probably not these black pants, like, not like skinny jeans. Well, you could wear skinny jeans, but black pants are, I think, the way to go. Or gray, you know, probably not shorts, even if it's hot out, just put pants on. I have this white dress shirt. It's nice. I would wear probably have a bow tie and a long skinny tie. I would probably wear this with it. So, like a nice dress shirt with tie. And lots of people have trouble finding clothes that fit them, whether the clothes are too big or too small. My tip is just find a dress shirt that you like in your size, or as close to your size as you can get it. Take it in to get tailored. It'll cost a little bit extra money, but they look so nice when they actually fit you. And then, I mean, you don't have to wear a tie. I think a tie will be nice. You can wear a bow tie if you want, because they're pretty cool. But ties are a little more classy. They're just simple and nice. If you want, if it's like a really, you know, like, so, like if it's an important job, you know, not like a coffee shop or a grocery store or something like that, you can wear a suit. Again, take it in to get tailored. It'll cost some extra money, but it looks like a billion times better. I personally wouldn't wear a suit because I first of all, I would never have a job that requires a suit, but I don't know, not really my thing. You can always get a vest. So a nice little black vest. I have a ridiculous red one that I got from Value Village. Don't wear crazy things. Honestly, you can present yourself however you want to, but you don't want anything crazy. Just go for simple and clean. If you don't have the money for a dress shirt or to get things tailored, just wear a nice white t-shirt and some black pants. Really, that's, you don't need to go all fancy. That would work. Don't wear some like crazy t-shirt, like even just black, just wear a black t-shirt and black pants. Try to have your, you know, just slightly put together. Like, I think black and white is just solid, good interview colors to wear. I don't know, if you're going for a job at some crazy place, then dress crazy, but like even just like at a coffee shop or a grocery store, some retail place, just keep it simple. I'm gonna go out and try and find some jobs soon, actually, myself, because I have no money. I hope you guys have good luck going out there getting jobs, just, and if, you're not passing 100%, but you'd like to be gendered correctly, I don't know. Some places are super cool about it, I guess some places aren't. You could ask if you could have something other than your birth name on your name tag. So you don't even have to bring up the fact that you're trans, just maybe ask if you could have this name on your name tag. If they ask you why, say you like that name better, like or if you know that the environment is safe, then you can tell them. Assess the people that you're working with that are hiring you. If you want to get the job, it's best just to do what works for them. And once you get it, once you work there, if you're a little bit more familiar with the people, then maybe you can sort it out later. It just depends. That's pretty much my two bits. Just be you, but try to be as calm in your wardrobe as you can be, I think is kind of the key. Have a fabulous week. I'll see you next Sunday. Love you all, as always. Peace.